This is chapter 10, and it has quite a bit of information in it. Again, I am looking at the Prezi outline and trying to just fill it in a little bit with you. And it starts out with the Nashville sound. Read about Patsy Cline, one of the most famous performers of this time period. And the Nashville sound is a little bit harder to describe, but it is country and a very sophisticated type of a sound. It can be described as country music, but with a lot of orchestral sounds in the background, strings, and full orchestra. And then also with a lot of background singers or just a less twangy sound. The background singers might be more melodic or smooth. And so it's an attempt to take country music and make it more appealing to the masses. Some people that are associated with that are listed right here with Jim Reeves and Floyd Kramer, Brenda Lee, Connie Francis. Even Elvis is considered part of this sound, and another reason why he was extraordinarily popular. Charlie Pride, Ray Charles, which probably there will be a question about Ray Charles and his life. There's a great movie with him that you should check out, just called Ray. And, excuse me. So these performers, the most important ones are probably Elvis and Ray Charles. But you can take a look at all of those in the Nashville sound. Underneath that, I've got James Brown, Sam Cooke, and Aretha Franklin, and they are part of this term, which is basically soul music, which is a new term. It didn't really get used until the late 1960s, but then was quickly picked up. This also includes performers like Curtis Mayfield, Otis Redding, and Sly Stone. Listen to the music, you know some of it, Georgia on My Mind, which is actually just an old Tin Pan Alley song, and then later on became the state song of Georgia, and made popular by Ray Charles. Sam Cooke's considered the king of soul. James Brown is the godfather of soul. And if you've never watched James Brown perform, well, you just need to. It'll change your life. Aretha Franklin, read about her, still performing, still one of the greatest singers. I wish I could tell you more about that, again, seeing some videos of that would probably help the most. She's not really a pop singer, but she's made her name mainly because of her talent. Probably her most famous song is Respect, R-E-S-P-E-C-T, and I'll bet a lot of you already know that one too. Also in this section then, or in this chapter, they start talking about urban folk music and the incomparable Bob Dylan. Bob Dylan's probably one of the most important pop icons of the 20th century. I'm sure you've heard of him on the news, accepting and not accepting the Peace Prize. But his early influences in the urban folk music scene cannot be overstated, along with performers like Joan Baez and Judy Collins. Again, listen to the music, Blowing in the Wind, Mr. Tambourine Man, Like a Rolling Stone. These are all classics from that time period. Bob Dylan's career was very turbulent, though, because midway through his career, he decided to go more electric guitars, and caused quite a stir in some of the concerts that he was performing at. Also includes people like Simon and Garfunkel. There's a small section about musical theater in the 60s. Burt Bacharach is known as one of the popular songwriters of this time. Again, still alive, still doing things. It's a very small little section, but take a look at it, and there will probably be a question about that. The most important thing in the 60s was probably the introduction to the world of the Beatles and the Rolling Stones. There's a lot to talk about that. This entire time period, though, is referenced sometimes as a counterculture, anti-establishment. Even nowadays, we're seeing young people acting this way, much like they did back then in the 60s, which is just opposing so many things that were going wrong. Back then, it was civil rights issues, the Vietnam War, This is that time period of rock and roll, long hair, beards, blue jeans, tie-dye shirts, free love, drugs, especially LSD, anti-authoritarian and anti-establishment. There's a list of some of the famous singers of this time. Those under at the bottom: Janis Joplin, Jerry Garcia, sorry about that, Jimi Hendrix, and Eric Clapton, Jefferson Airplane. These are all coming out of California. This is West Coast rock and roll, basically. The Beatles and the Rolling Stones, obviously, they're coming from, this is the start of what has been called the British Invasion. And we'll talk more about that as in the second wave. But the first wave was the Beatles coming over and also the Rolling Stones. San Francisco is the epicenter for the people like Joplin and Garcia. Even though Janis Joplin was born in Texas, moved quickly to the California scene, and basically became a hippie like everybody else at the time. And all of them are worth reading about. And again, there's plenty of listening for this. It also includes, I'm not sure if it's listed there, Jim Morrison. Nope. But Jim Morrison and the Doors is something good to take a look at also in there.